Never stop being good, even if the world is not appreciating you. Hello world, this is R.E.D for Fitness by Abhinav Tonk, and today's topic of discussion is science behind losing or gaining weight. Let me introduce two terms in front of you. First one is calorie in, second one is calorie out. So calorie in is the amount of energy which you gain by eating food, whereas calorie out is the total energy expenditure. So I have already explained what is total energy expenditure in my previous video. So the gaining or losing of weight depends on the difference of these two parameters, that is calorie in minus calorie out. So there will be three scenarios in this case. First scenario is when calorie in is greater than calorie out. So in this case, calorie in minus calorie out will be a positive number, or you can say that your body will be in positive energy balance. So in this case, the positive energy balance will be converted into the body fat or muscles or liver or muscle glycogen. In this case, you will gain weight. So what's happening here? Energy, positive energy balance, due to positive energy balance, excess energy is getting converted into mass. Now comes the second case. In this case, calorie in is less than calorie out. So calorie in minus calorie out will be a negative number, or you can say your body is in negative energy balance. So in order to compensate negative energy balance, body stored fat or muscles or liver or muscle glycogen gets converted into energy in order to compensate this deficit balance. In this case, you will lose weight. Third scenario is where calorie in is exactly equal to calorie out. So in this case, calorie in minus calorie out will be zero. So you will neither gain weight nor you will lose weight. So let me explain this or summarize this concept in my detailed explanation video. It will be more clear to you then.
I have already told you two terms, calorie in and calorie out. Let me write it as C in and C out. So C in is the energy received by eating food, whereas C out will be the total energy expenditure. So I've already discussed in my previous video how do we calculate TEE. For that we have to calculate BMR, then from BMR and deciding your PAL factor, you will be able to calculate TEE. Now there will be three scenarios. First scenario is when C in is greater than C out. So we are looking for this difference, right? So in first case, delta C, when we will calculate by C in minus C out, so C in is greater than C out, it will come as the positive number. So there will be the positive balance in the energy balance in the body. So C in is the energy in and C out is the energy, total energy expenditure. Remaining delta C remains in our body. So this positive balance is converted into body fat or muscles or glycogen. So what's happening here? Energy is converting into mass. Now second case, when C in is less than C out. So in this case, delta C will be a negative number. What's happening here? You are consuming C in and C out is the total energy expenditure. So in order to compensate this total energy expenditure, as we have negative energy balance in our body, so the stored body fat or muscles or glycogen will provide this negative energy balance in order to compensate the negative energy balance. What will happen in this case? You will lose weight. And in the above case, or in the above scenario, you will gain weight. So in this case, mass is, stored mass in our body is getting converted into energy. Now, third and the last case, when C in is equal to C out. So here delta C will be zero. So what will happen? You are taking some calories, and exact number of calories you are spending. So nothing is remaining, zero calories are remaining. So in this case, no change in weight. You will neither gain weight nor you will lose weight. No change in weight.
I hope the concept of gaining or losing weight is clear to you now. If you like this video, kindly like, share and subscribe my channel R.E.D for Fitness. You can also like my page on Facebook R.E.D for Fitness. See you soon in the next video. Take care.